It's been 3 hours. We could play it.
I feel like it's gonna be short. It can't be that long if it's just a bonus episode of us as kids. This is all new too, I haven't.
Ready, I guess. But isn't your mom gonna freak? She's probably cooking with the radio on. She won't hear a thing.
Oh my god.
I bet she'll notice a hole in the floor. Trust in science, Max. Even when science means blowing shit up.
Yeah. Oh my god. Damn, that's a long ass fuse. Bruh.
Tell me that wasn't the coolest thing you've ever seen.
That was truly amazing. Why are explosions so awesome?
That's like asking why are puppies cute. Some things just are.
Fair.
I'm not sure your mom would see it that way.
When she asked me to get rid of my old junk, she never specified how. But I guess I better do some actual cleaning, too. I'll be excavating the closet. If you see anything else to trash, help a girl out and chuck it on the pile over there.
Fair enough. Alright, we're back to playing Max one more time.
It feels like I've spent half my life hanging out in this room.
Do I feel that?
Probably because I have. I can't believe those days are all over now. In a few days, my whole family moves to Seattle. I have no idea when I'll see Chloe again. This could be my last chance to say goodbye. Tell your best friend that you're leaving her. I better help Chloe with her cleaning. And while I'm at it, I can take one long last look around this place.
I was wondering what they were going to do for this episode, because I didn't know if it was just going to be like some random memory and it's going to be like good times between them, but I'm liking the fact that they're setting it right before like shit hits the fan.
Chloe's mom wanted us to go through this pile of old clothes and find stuff to donate. Instead, we played dress up for an hour. Chloe's had this hung up on her wall forever, but neither of us can figure out what happened to the last panel.
Supermax and
Dr. Kloenstein's okay.
And Dr. Kloenstein. Our crime fighting has really soared since you created those rocket boosters. Of course, the power of flight does tend to make things easier. Dr. Kloenstein?
Chloe's always preferred imaginary animals to real ones. Besides Bongo. This was our first unsupervised concert together.
Unsupervised concert.
So much fun. We were supposed to see another show next month.
How sick was that show?
The sickest.
I've been working on my moves for the next one.
Oh yeah?
Check it out.
Nice.
How about you? Any new moves?
Yeah, totally. I've been working on my air guitar.
That's so great.
Damn, Caulfield. Save something for when it counts. All right. Back to the junk mines.
Chloe? Chloe and I haven't played this game in forever. And I'm pretty sure it's missing pieces.
What are you doing?
Adding this to the pile.
No freaking way. Just because I beat your ass every time we play doesn't make it trash.
Right. Right.
Chloe, we haven't played this game in years. And it's missing half the pieces.
Nice try, Max. But you can't erase your shame that easily.
Not that.
Let this box of trash be a sacrifice to you, oh almighty Chloe Bear. Chloe keeps trying to get me to hop on her board. I'd rather take pictures.
Belt.
Chloe's such a nerd. She hangs on to all her old textbooks and school supplies. Live fast, die young, and go out with a bang. Rest in pieces, doll.
Oh my god.
Whoa. Not embarrassing.
Not that.
How about these boy band trading cards? Super cringeworthy.
Yeah, and hilarious. Remember when we gave them all makeovers?
You mean when you drew boobs on all of them? I was so mad at you.
And yet, our friendship lived on. So too will these cards.
Damn. She doesn't want to get rid of shit.
Chloe's had this hoodie for years. It's her favorite. I don't think she'd mean to throw it away. Chloe's been beating me for a while. That growth spurt could come any day now.
Nah, Max stays short.
What are you doing?
Your favorite hoodie. You must have thrown it in by
mistake. Oh, bro, the holes.
It's fine. It's filled with holes. And falling apart.
That never stopped you from running before.
It's fine. Really.
What the fuck is that? Is that a jawbreaker?
We bought this as a gag years ago. I honestly can't believe Chloe still has it.
Oh my god, remember the electric gum that they have in there? Oh my god, that's a throwback.
What about this half-eaten jawbreaker? It's a serious biohazard.
You promised me we'd finish it together no matter how long it took. Don't be a quitter.
I know Max would toss that shit. Ain't no way in hell.
Your mom and your dentist will thank me.
So lame. Just so lame.
Okay, whenever I'm ready, I can go tell Chloe I'm done arguing about trash with her. I think Chloe used to call this guy Mr. Sharky. I doubt she plays with it anymore. That was awesome. Who else but Chloe?
I know, literally.
Cleaning her room into a pyrotechnical adventure. People say a lot of things about the Prescott family, but this is pretty cool.
Yikes.
I was lucky to survive Chloe's magic phase with all my fingers intact. Hey, what's your dad's camera doing in here?
Dad said I could bring it up here for you to use. He's tired of watching you drool all over yourself every time he uses it.
Oh.
Your dad is the best.
Sure. Just don't ever tell him that.
Okay. It hasn't happened yet. I figured it had. I thought it happened after.
You're off to a great start.
Actually, it's kind of cool.
Mm-hmm. Polaroids for the win.
This seems like a good candidate. Are you insane? The entire magic collection. Do you know how many weeks of allowances cost?
You haven't touched these since the Great Talent Show.
Maybe because my assistant turned out to be squeamish at the sight of fake blood.
At least you didn't saw me in half. How are you planning to clean this place if you won't throw away anything?
Not the line skipping again.
I bet Chloe's parents were freaking out.
I still can't
believe you're a Blackwell Academy student. How is it?
Oh, the classes are incredible. The teachers are actually smart.
Damn.
And the lab is legit. Petri dishes for days.
What about the students? Are they as stuck up as you thought they'd be?
They're fine.
Chloe, you're terrible at Is everything okay?
I don't know. I like hanging out with normal people. Like, you.
Thanks. I guess.
I hate fake people. You're real.
Thanks.
You better not be thinking. I think you are.
Chloe, I haven't seen you touch this guy in years. Why do you care?
Why do I care? If you don't want a stupid childhood friend,
oh my god. Bruh.
Sorry, chum.
That's better.
Oh yeah, she hurting.
As usual, Chloe's grades are better than mine. I still kick her butt in PE, though.
Alright. Interesting, a lie-down option instead of a sit. Hasn't told her? Bruh. Oh, rip. This is gonna be a sad one today, folks.
Exactly the purge mom was hoping for, but at least we tried, right?
Right.
And now we've got the whole day ahead of us. What do two undersupervised friends with
undersupervised
clean slates want to get into today?
Clean rooms. The fuck is?
Now would be a good time to tell Chloe I'm leaving. Or I could let us enjoy the day first and tell her later.
If I tell her later, then it'll be like a normal day. If I tell her now, then sure, she'll be sad about it all day, but like, it might make the day more special in terms of like, if we tell her now, then it could be like, okay, then we gotta do this, like, today. We have to do whatever the fuck we want. I think we'll do more adventurous shit if we tell her now.
Actually, Chloe, I really have to tell you something. It's... I... don't know how to...
Shit! Max, hold that thought. This must have fallen out when I was digging around in here. Do you have any idea what this
2003.
Is?
2003. Pirate related.
Whatever it is, it looks like it came out of our pirate phase.
The powers of deduction are as strong as ever.
Right.
This tape is from 5 years ago. It's a message from our past selves to our current selves.
Oh, man.
So we were 8 years old? That's crazy. I can't even imagine what we sounded like.
Ready to find out?
Avast, future wayfarer! We have uncovered the audio log of the most fearsome pirates in the bays of Arcadia!
Oh, girl. We were such dorks.
So, you're in search of buried treasure, are ye? Well, treasure ye seek.
It's in the backyard. Oh my god, will you?
Get away! We're in the middle of an important project!
Oh, project. Never mind then. I apologize.
I mean it!
Alright, alright. Supper's at 5. Wash your hands, you grubby pirate kids.
So lame. As I was saying, if it's treasure you seek, you come to the right place. But be forewarned. The journey will be treacherous and full of treacherous.
Nice.
Treachers.
To find the treasure of Price Isle, you will need the map from the manuscript of Captain Bluebeard.
Only those with pure... Only those with pure hearts will be able to see what the amulet shows them.
The amulet.
I wonder why there's so many lines being skipped.
Dude, that was so dorky. What were we thinking?
I thought we were lovable. Okay, okay. Forget everything. Today, we go treasure hunting. I think I know what 8-year-old you meant by the manuscripts of Captain Bluebeard.
Our old sketchbook. This is where we kept all.
Oh my god, that is such
memories.
A big tagline on it.
See this map.
It's huge. Property of Captain Bluebeard and Long Max Silver. Keep out, Mom. Hey, at least they got that right. Treasure keep, cannons, the galley, okay, saloon, the crow's nest, cockpit. Oh my god. Pogo the pirate. Amazing. No bathing, no poison the ship, no sharing pirate secrets, always share plunder, always bury treasure, always protect fellow pirates. Failure to obey these rules will result in plank walking. Another day of plunder and destruction on the high seas. Our just buried treasure has come under attack again. The evil commander, Shelley, enemy to all pirates, has threatened to take the map from us if she sees it. Surely she has heard how valuable our treasure is and wants to steal it from us. We are doing our best to keep the map hidden as we continue to work on it, because our enemies want our treasure so bad. We must make sure the map is only readable to us. Captain Bluebeard and Long Max Silver to more plunder and riches.
This looks like a page was ripped out. I wonder if it's the map.
I wonder. Probably.
Hey, check this out. This page was ripped out. Do you think it's the map?
If it is, there's no way I would have thrown it out. Maybe it's mixed in with the rest of the drawings?
Maybe it's the back of the comic
so
strip?
So much for telling Chloe now. All she cares about is finding this map. Where could it be? Don't move. This angle is perfect.
Why be shy? Get in here, dude. Subject and photographer. You really do it all.
We try. Relatable.
I remember writing this. It's a story where you choose what happens.
A period.
I wonder if I could still get to the end.
Max and Chloe's sewer adventure. You are Max and Chloe, the best friends and students in school. You sit in class until suddenly a cute squirrel arrives at the window. It is so cute. Do you want to pet it? Pet the squirrel? Don't pet the squirrel. Page 8. You go to the window and pet the squirrel. Of course, why wouldn't you? It's a cute squirrel and you want to pet it. Hey, Mr. Squirrel, you say. Oh, stop biting me, you say, because the squirrel is now biting your hand. But it's too late. You have rabies. Mrs. Anders has to shoot you so you don't bite anyone else. This makes her very sad. Guess you should have pet the squirrel. Not that. Why don't you like squirrels? They're so cute and nice. You must be very mean. The squirrel seems annoyed that you ignored her. She runs in and steals the book report right off your desk, then runs back outside. The squirrel stole my book report, you told the teacher. Oh, huh. Whatever you say, Mrs. Anders responds, clearly not believing you. What do? Chase a squirrel, stay in class. Chase a squirrel. As soon as Miss Anders turns around, you run out the window and chase a squirrel. That is a very bad thing to do, and you hope you don't get in trouble later, but you probably will. Outside, you look around, but you can't find the squirrel. Is she gone? Oh, there she is. She's standing next to a sewer hole. You run up to her, but she gets scared and jumps down. Oh boy, do you really want to go down there? Jump down the sewer. You are very stupid brave. You leap down to the sewer. Thankfully, there's a pile of trash, banana peels, and dirty diapers to land on. Phew! You hear a squirrely sound in the distance, so you run to follow it. There are many twists and turns. Eventually, you come to a fork in the road. But now it's time for eating, so you put the fork back down and consider the two paths in front of you. On the ground, you see a trail of tiny footprints to the left and a trail of chewed-up paper to the right. Which way do you go? The right. Smart choice! You go to the right, following the path of chewed papers. After a bit of walking, you end up in a dark corner. Suddenly, the floor falls away. You find yourself swimming in some sort of warm liquid, almost like a big puddle, except, why does this liquid taste like acorns? A bright light comes on. It turns out you're not in a puddle, you're in a big bowl of acorn soup. And all around you are squirrels, holding spoons and wearing tiny little aprons. They look so cute, and the soup keeps getting hotter. Guess you weren't too smart after all. At least you'll be delicious. Okay, so we go to the left. Page 7. Oh, wait, no, page 9. You picked right. I mean left. Which was right? It's confusing. In the distance, you see the squirrel, but he's not moving. In fact, he's dead! Who would kill a poor squirrel? Suddenly, the ground begins to shake. Around the corner, a giant rat appears. It's the biggest rat you've ever seen. The biggest anything you've ever seen. It's the Rat King. The Rat King is wearing a crown and standing on a throne of all your missing homework, including your book report. What do? Run towards it. Your dad always tells you to run toward your problems, not away from them. Unfortunately, you picked a really bad time to start listening to him. You run right towards the Rat King. At first, he seems surprised. You try to punch him in his face, but you forgot about his long, hairy, gross tail. He wraps you up like a boa constrictor and drops you into his mouth, swallowing you with one gulp. Now you get to see what the inside of a rat looks like. This would make a great science report. Too bad you won't be alive to tell anyone. Not that. Okay, run away, page 5. You run away like a scaredy cat. I don't blame you. That thing is gross. As you run, you almost trip on a small shiny object. You pick it up. It's a lighter. Your mom never tells you to play with these, but she's not here right now, is she? Now is your chance to kill the Rat King and protect all the students' homework once and for all. This is your chance to be a hero. Do you do it? Just kidding, you don't get a choice. You may get to choose some things, but I'm still the author here. You have to attack the Rat King, but how do you want to attack him? Burn his tail, burn his throne, burn his tail. You decide to burn his gross, long, hairy tail. Good plan. Whoosh. The rat's tail is on fire. He does not like that one bit. He starts freaking out, waving his tail around like crazy. You know all the trash and dirty diapers in the sewer? Those are highly inflammable, which means the same as flammable, for some reason. Suddenly, the entire sewer catches fire. You're surrounded by gross sewer flames. Is this really how you die, burning to death with the Rat King in a disgusting sewer? Yes, it is. The end.
Damn, we died like
4 or 5 times. Okay, so we run away. Burn his throne. 13. You decide to burn the Rat King's throne. It hurts you to burn all of that amazing homework, including your wonderful book report, but you remember that it's for a good reason. As soon as the throne catches on fire, the Rat King begins screaming, "No, my throne!" Suddenly, the Rat King begins to shrink. Before long, he is back to the size of a normal rat. He can't even climb out of his huge crown. Aw, he's so cute now. You run back to class and tell Mrs. Anders all about the Rat King and everything that happened. Not only does she forgive you for not having your book report, but she declares you are the greatest hero in the school. Duh. The end. Until the next Max and Chloe adventure. This is so inventive, Maxine and Chloe, but next time please do the book report you were assigned. Relatable.
Yes. Take that, Rat King.
I've done shit like that. Like, do something that's, like, technically a loophole in the assignment. Okay. So, we did all that.
Chloe and I were doing a lot of drawing in Miss Shelley's class.
Great job as always, Chloe. Now please try to pay attention in class.
With her school supplies from that year. This looks like a page was ripped out. I wonder if it's the map. People say a lot of things about the Prescott family, but this is pretty cool.
Okay, so I guess she's gonna find it then.
Any luck? Nope. You? Nothing yet.
What the fuck? Yeah, it said, I wonder if it's mixed in with the rest of her homework, but I tried checking her backpack. Oh, maybe. Okay, in here. Yep, I see a page sticking out.
Bingo.
Chloe's secret lair. The photo. Chloe's secret lair. To the dark cavern. The amulets in the dark cavern. Then we go to Treasure Island, and then we're at the Price Castle. Not the subtitles being stuck.
Amulet, which we hid inside a dark cavern, aka the attic. Ugh.
There's an attic?
Why did we do that to ourselves? Because we were 8 years old and the attic was the scariest place we could think of.
You think it's still there?
Should be. As long as the clean police haven't gotten to it first.
Okay, and once we have the amulet and the telescope, we use them to reveal the treasure. Somehow.
Here's what's happening. I'll head to the garage to dig up my old telescope. You go find that amulet. We'll meet out back at the pirate ship.
Alright.
You mean the swings?
The swing.
Yes, the pirate ship. Captain Bluebeard and Long Max Silver right again, bitches!
Fucking Chloe.
Way to talk Chloe later. If this has to be my last day here, might as well have one final pirate adventure.
Alright. Yeah, that seems fitting for them.
Okay.
Chloe Bro.
Said she hid the amulet in the attic. The only way in is through the broom closet. It seems like Chloe's dad always has a project around the house. Makeup is great for acting your home in costumes. Any other time, I just don't get it. Chloe's mom bought me a toothbrush because I spend the night here so often.
Period.
Well, I used to. The things inside this cabinet haven't changed very much over the years.
It's about to.
I guess Chloe never really grew out of wanting to be a pirate. Slipped and broke this post.
Shit.
But Chloe insisted on taking all the blame. Even after she got grounded, she never squealed.
Cause she ain't. She ain't no snitch. That's why.
I can't believe I won't be able to call Arcadia Bay home much longer. I wonder if I'll ever take this view in again.
I'm wondering if I should...
I don't think I've ever actually...
Restart.
...anyone reading these books. I always like to imagine I could open that wardrobe and step into another. I don't think I could ever handle a real-life murder investigation.
Why is it stuck?
It's awesome that Chloe's mom wants to teach kids.
Oh, that's what she wanted to do? Damn.
Low strikes? How can that be so cool and so dorky at the same time? Chloe hasn't mentioned a trip. Maybe it's supposed to be a surprise.
From Portland to Phoenix.
Chloe's such a nature nerd. I bet she's gonna love it. Chloe's mom is trying to quit smoking.
Period.
The principal at Blackwell wants to meet with Chloe's parents. I wonder if Chloe get into a fight. She never gets in trouble. I'm glad her dad stood up for her. A voicemail? I wonder if it's still there. Sometimes I really wish I had siblings. Aww. Chloe's parents are so cute.
Alright. Well then I mean, I'm sure I'm gonna be going downstairs anyway. I always thought about using one of those crates to reach something, but I always thought about, like, when I've stood on them, they look so unreliable.
It's a start. I gotta find something I can stack on top of it.
I didn't even see that there.
Almost there. I just need a few more inches.
I feel like that looks like it would be tall enough. What the fuck else? What can I put on there?
Am I
grabbing? Not the chair.
Chloe's room has always been home base.
I've got to hurry to think this might be the last Chloe out back plan.
Seems like Chloe's dad always has a project around the house.
So there is something in the bathroom?
I guess Chloe never really grew out of wanting to be a pirate.
What the fuck? I searched all of this shit. What else is there? Oh, the books. I thought it wasn't gonna be the books after I went by it the first couple times.
I think that should be tall enough.
That is a fat ass cobweb.
Awesome.
I'm like, bro, there's a light switch right there.
Man, there is a ton of stuff up here. How will I ever? There it is. Of course, Chloe hid the amulet in the hardest place to get to. Her parents couldn't run away through. I guess I see it when Chloe gets this into my tower.
Hey, there it goes. It's finally back to normal. There is so much.
I think I can squeeze through now.
There's so much shit in here.
Jack. That's full of decorations Chloe made when she was five. She thinks they're embarrassing, but I think they're cute. It's a good thing I'm big and burly. Otherwise, moving this furniture would be kind of difficult.
Oh, fuck.
Crap. Not a single country record. These must belong to Chloe's mom.
Not her moving all this fucking furniture just to get to an amulet. Closer. School cooler. That's kind of tight. Low key.
Yes.
Why do I feel like she's gonna fall through the floor? Attics have never seemed reliable to me.
Finally. A fitting reward for a journey full of treasures. This is a nice close-up shot. I wish I could remember how it works.
What's a broken window?
Chloe Price. My best friend. It's so weird being back in this attic after so long. I remember being terrified of this place. I think when you're a kid, you're only afraid of things that can hurt you. But when you get older, you become more afraid of hurting the people you care about.
Damn.
And spiders.
Not the the bottle.
Man, I'm gonna miss her.
I like that angle the most. Wholesome moments.
Are you just watching me up there, Creeper?
You are one of a kind, Curtis.
What?
I'm lucky you're my best friend.
Damn right you are, you mushy weirdo. Find the amulet? Awesome. Now get your ass down here. We have treasure to find.
On my way.
I hope it just speeds past. Okay, cool. I was like, just go past the broom closet part.
Dude, you did it!
No big deal.
Bring the amulet over here so I can see.
Chloe is so excited. I better bring her the amulet before she makes me walk the plank. Chloe's bottle rocket. The fastest way to get an entire bottle of soda in her hair.
Sounds about right.
I'm really gonna miss Price family barbecues. It's not that I don't like the blue. I'm just sad to see the old color go. One time, we stuck a bunch of this tape to Chloe's face to make a blue beard.
Oh,
the was a lot more fun than taking it off. This was a
nice.
Fun experiment. I'm almost surprised we actually managed to grow something. Poor Bongo.
Dang.
Chloe took his death so hard. I guess Chloe's mom comes all the way back here to smoke. Chloe and I have done lots of homework at this table. It's so weird we're at different schools now. I still wish I could live in the world we drew.
Work of art. I call it. Oh, I lost my magnifying glass privileges.
Oh my god.
Great art is never appreciated.
Yo-ho, yo-ho, a pirate's rum for me. Do you drink this? Yar. No, not really. I'm gonna push an empty bottle from the recycling.
That's probably for the best.
Some pirate you are.
Hey, Chloe.
Yar.
Yar.
Land ho.
Period.
Perfect.
Yeah, where was that last one? Oh yeah, throw the bowl.
I've spent so much of my life here. Every little corner is familiar. Comforting. These games we're playing. Buried pirate treasure from our past selves. Is this all selfish of me? Why is this making me feel more guilty about leaving? How am I going?
What's up, dude?
Bro.
Bro. Nerd.
Maybe I meant nerd.
door.
Hunk.
Hunk. Hunks are cool.
Oh, we know Chloe.
You know what, Max Caulfield?
What, Chloe Price?
You're the frickin' best. That's all.
Period.
Damn right. About time you realized it.
Tell anyone and I'll deny it. Okay, enough of this shit. There's treasure to be unburying.
This thing looks so much smaller than I remember. I can't believe Chloe still has it.
I really like the lighting on that.
That was cool.
I can. Glider swings. The best way to simulate a storm on the high seas.
Alright, I think now I can give her the amulet.
I never understood why it's called a Jolly Roger. How jolly can you be if you're dead?
That's actually true. I just found that out recently. That's kind of crazy.
Wait just a minute. Yarr! You must ask permission before setting foot, peg, on another captain's boat.
Permission to come aboard, Captain Bluebeard?
Grrr!
One amulet. Coming right up.
Okay, I think it goes... Damn it. I forget how to make this stay on.
Stay here. I think I saw some tape.
Thanks, Max.
Just some tape left between us and the treasure. I wish this was big enough to jump in.
That is...
It'll be totally diveable in a few weeks.
Yep.
Yeah. A few weeks.
Damn. Yeah, it's so true, though. When all the leaves pile up, if you live in, like, a Four Seasons area, all those leaves just fucking stack, and you could just fall back into them.
Score. One step closer to getting that treasure. Whatever it is.
One time, I think one of my friends ended up doing that, and it was too shallow, and he just went through the leaves and hit the fucking pavement.
Avast, lady. Have you brought me prize?
Ahoy, Bluebeard. I have brought the stickiest tape in all the seven seas.
Well done, fellow scallywag. Just like old times. Come on.
Remember how we used to talk about ruining the bays of our feet one day? We thought we were gonna be pirates forever.
The hot dog man kite.
If being a pirate means acting silly and going on crazy adventures together, then we'll always be pirates.
Hell yeah. To do the honors, Long Max Silver?
Mm-hmm. Are you sure?
Of course. Come on, Navigator. Point me to some treasure.
Wait. How am I supposed to use this?
You're drawing on the lens. It should line up with something.
Here goes nothing. Okay. This drawing is supposed to line up with something.
What the fuck? Bitch, where? Oh, because I can spin. Lol. Oh.
I'm so close. I just need to keep looking.
There it is.
Yes! You rock! Where is it? Here?
Okay, take a step right.
No, no. The other right.
My other right or your other right? Your other right. Sure thing. Wait, what?
Oh my god.
Just go that way. Perfect. Now come towards me.
Boom.
Bingo.
Girl, we just lost a spot. Wonder what's down there.
Dun dun dun.
What is this? I don't know. Let's open it. From Bloody Bill. Who's that? I'll get the tape player.
Oh, William.
Uh-huh. Chloe's dad is such a goofball.
Ahoy there, plankwalkers! It's me, Bloody Bill, the Pirate King.
What the heck?
By now you'll have seen that I dug up your treasure, which would normally make us mortal enemies. But hear me out. I haven't pilfered a thing. On the contrary, I figured you swashbucklers might not be back to your loot for some time, so I've given an extra protection from the winds and rain. I'm sure you're excited to open your time capsule, so I won't go on too long. Just know that Bloody Bill is bloody proud of you. Both of you. Keep those sails trimmed and that anchor scrubbed. And always remember, the real treasure is...
friendship.
Oh my god.
Your Oregon State college savings plan.
Oh my god.
That's what we originally buried.
Huh, yeah. I guess it probably would have gotten ruined underground. Holy crap! It's Billy the Squid! He's alive!
He's alive!
Oh, man!
It really is like a time capsule.
No way!
Chloe, look at this. We wrote each other letters.
Oh, I remember these. Chloe Price. Thanks, Max. I hope you are having a lot of fun being a teenager with your best friend. Aw, you're so cute. Check it out.
Ugh, Maxine.
Maxine. Dear Chloe, how are you today? I'm doing very well. It is Friday, June 27, 2003. It is summer vacation. We are making a time capsule for you and me in the future. We are making it pirate theme. Wasn't it hilarious to find? These are some things we like. Favorite animal, Arabian horse, Max. Otter, Chloe. Favorite food, lobster roll, Max. Coffee, ice cream, Chloe. I like both of those. Favorite class in school, art or library, Max. Science, Chloe, yeah. Best friend, each other, both. How about you? Are you age 12 or more? What are your favorite foods, movies, etc.? That's all for now. I hope you're having a lot of fun being a teenager with your best friend. Sincerely, Maxine Caulfield.
How about mine? What did I write?
This is so Chloe.
Dear Maxine, hello from 2003. Here is a record of how we spend our days. Can you guess which one is real? We go to the same school and always sit together at lunch. Duh. We have sleepovers at least once a week. We like extremely salty pretzels. We are in a race to see who can convince your parents to get a pet first. We're going to live together when we can afford it and use only gold paint. We have battled many foes and never failed to save each other. What did you guess? If you guess all of them, you are right. Your friend forever, Chloe Elizabeth Price.
You were really funny. Mine was so serious.
Oh yeah, it's you. Serious and gentle.
This is so cool. There's so much to look at. Is your mom going to mind about this mess?
Just don't know. I thought they'd be home by now.
Max, remember scratch art? Oh, I love this stuff.
I'm gonna draw something.
Oh my god. Oh, that's right, the voice message also.
All these memories. I want to look at everything. It's good to see you, old friend. Recording things was so much fun in third grade. It actually might be really fun to write letters to Chloe after I move, when I run out of things to say. Most of these are pretty far off base. It's so hard to predict the future. Maybe it's better.
Both of us are medium popular. Relatable. Both of us are dating our second boyfriend. We don't make decisions without consulting each other. The talking skull of our enemies. Chloe has visited Antarctica. Max could rave come if she wanted. One of us has a little sister or brother. We're doing well in school.
These are awesome.
Switches Chloe's pedals from wheels to
cool things to do.
Wheels to blades. Also spins blades. World's most comfortable seat. Flaming fingers, flint and steel. Oh yeah, that would be cool. Like a snap, at a snap of a fingers, you have fire. Ray of sunshine, sunlight enters here. Mirrors and lenses to strengthen sunlight. Laser beam shoots out here. Open intake window. Okay, period.
Holy crap!
Hey, there it is.
The end of that comic in Chloe's room.
Maybe you should come down and power a flight this dude's face off with me, bruh.
This container looks like it could last 100 years. We always make so much more of a mess here than at my house. Manga might be the one thing where Chloe out nerds me.
Shocker.
I love how Polaroid cameras make every photo look a little nostalgic.
Yep.
This is probably the last thing Chloe's mom wants to see after a shift at the diner.
Period. Of course, it's Max. Damn, bro, she cleaned up.
That was a good week. I used every possible excuse to be here for breakfast. I always look especially short next to Chloe.
Yep, that's the infamous photo.
Chloe's grandparents live in Idaho now. I guess, compared to that, Seattle's not so far. These used to make great pirates.
It's not that far, like, in terms of... It's 3 hours from Portland, so...
Goodbye,
it could still work, but, like...
Soon you won't have to worry about me knocking
it is. It's just not gonna be a every week kind of thing. That's all.
I wonder if that's the voicemail Chloe's mom was talking about. She did say she didn't want Chloe to hear it, but... If Chloe's in trouble at Blackwell... This might be my only chance to get her to talk about it.
True.
This is Ann Rogers, Marissa's mother. Marissa from Blackwell. I need to talk to you about what your daughter did to Marissa in class today. I'll be keeping Marissa home with me tomorrow. At this point, I'm not comfortable sending her back to school at all. I don't know if your daughter is having trouble adjusting or what, but this needs to be...
Hey, hold on. Are you serious? I don't want my parents to hear that. I've never gotten in trouble like this before.
They already know. I saw an email on your parents' computer. Shit.
Rip.
What happened?
Something so minor. Her mom is exaggerating. I bet Marissa told her that I... I'm telling you, it's stupid.
Come on. You've got to tell me what happened. I'm your best friend.
Man, none of this would have happened if I had you around. I wouldn't care what anyone said. Sorry. I don't mean it's your fault. Anyway, she wouldn't leave me alone, so I turned up her Bunsen burner and it's just...
Oh, bitch. What? Oh, my God.
I'm not hurt, not even close. You know that I knew what I'm doing.
Chloe, what do you mean she wouldn't leave you alone?
She was making fun of my clothes and calling me a scholarship kid.
Mm-hmm.
Is that why you wanted to throw away your hoodie?
Don't worry. I'll keep it.
Hey, you can handle this. You're so much cooler than she is.
Just to you.
Thanks, Max.
Damn, she walked away fast. Okay.
Goodbye, Vase. Soon you won't have to worry about me knocking you over anymore.
Alright, did I get everything? Oh, photo album.
Some really cute photos in there. I wonder if
oh my God.
Take this photo with Chloe now. Looks like Chloe's a lot more responsible than I am with my allowance. Hey, what if my being in Seattle finally convinces Chloe to try an MMO?
Yes.
Pose for a photo with that. Okay. Tip your head back and put your arms out. And a really big smile.
Like this?
It's perfect. Stop moving.
a solid sequel photo. I'm here for it.
Guess I should try talking to Chloe again about my news. I can do that after I finish looking at everything. I can't decide which version of this photo I like better. Chloe and I have been friends for so long. Maybe I'm worrying too much about this move changing things. This used to be the Rainy Day pirate ship. Chloe looks so content when she's dry.
Wait, I just realized that plot hole.
I look like when I'm taking pictures.
Yeah, I just realized the plot hole. How does that Polaroid exist if William's still alive?
I always look especially short next to Chloe.
Because that's the day he died. Plot hole.
You're such a space hog. Move over.
Nope.
Yeah, sounds about right.
I wish this moment could last forever.
All right, time to tell her.
Spilled that wine months ago, but I still feel bad about it. You sure were troublesome to find. That's so cool that Chloe's mom is thinking about this.
Oh my god, the infamous snow globe.
Something pretty to look at.
Okay. Think we got everything. Just do a photo.
Take a break for a second.
This artist waits for no stop. That was worth stopping for.
Period. Alright, we got a lot of photos in today.
Hey, hippie.
Hey, hippie! That sounds like Chloe.
Working on the last bit? How about you? Done with the time capsule?
Yeah, I think so.
Well, perfect, because now I'm finished. Check it out.
Max's first tattoo. Solid.
What tattoo am I getting?
A heart with my initials? There.
Oh. Chloe, you were really drawing me that whole time.
Whoa. Machine is alert. Keep it together, Max.
I guess now's my chance to tell Chloe I'm leaving. We might not be alone again once her parents get back.
Hey, ready for something else? I've got a great plan for the afternoon.
Crap. I don't want to ruin the rest of the day.
You're staying for dinner, right? Because this idea will be perfect at sunset.
Chloe didn't want me to tell her. She's already got enough drama from Blackwell. I don't want to add to it. It's just Seattle. I'm probably overstressing about the whole thing. Right? Chloe?
Max?
I want to tell you something.
Okay.
My family's moving to Seattle. Really soon. Hey.
In 3 days, right?
What?
Damn.
You knew that?
Our parents didn't talk, you know?
But they said I should be the one to tell you.
You still told my parents. I guess Mom and Dad were trying to keep quiet too, but they're bad at hiding anything. Don't look so worried, Max. It's okay. Come on, Dorfmeister. It's not the end of the world.
I should have just told you earlier. I feel so stupid.
Max, I said it was okay.
I was trying to tell you this morning, but
I totally distracted you with the pirate tape. Success.
Seriously?
I didn't want this hanging over us all day. Plus, I know you hate this kind of conversation, so... I just left it alone. You know? Come on. I want to spend every minute we have together having fun.
We'll keep in touch, okay? And visit, and maybe we'll move back. Who knows?
Chill out. We can go to college together. It's gonna be fun. We're Max and Chloe, remember? We're always together. Maybe we're not.
That's true.
Cool. Let's find something fun to do.
Well, I guess there's the plot.
Black flies on the window seat. We are the moon. Winter stole summer's three. And the river's cracked and cold. See, the sky is no man's land. A dark and plumed estate. Hope it needs a humble hand. Not a fox found in your place.
Maybe This was a dumb idea. I would give anything to be there with you now. It's so hard trying to say what I'm thinking. If I could just see you. But we'll get good at it. Great at it. We'll write and talk all the time. And then you'll come visit and it'll be like I never left. I mean it. You don't have to worry about anything changing. You're dealing with so much other stuff. You don't deserve any of this. Chloe, listen. Even if I never... Even if we're moving for good, we are always together, okay? Even when we're apart, we're still Max and Chloe. I will always, always love you.
Damn. And that is the end of our Life is Strange series. Damn. It is, like... It sucks to have to end on such a sad note in terms of, like, the series as in terms of, like, that being a bonus episode kind of idea. But I'm glad that they made the bonus episode about literally, like, the one thing we just don't know what happened that day. Besides the car accident. So that was cool. And we did it. And now life is back to normal. Was there even choices in the farewell? No, there isn't. Okay.